We're getting ready to prepare, practice. Get ready for Pittsburgh State. We got a big week coming ahead. So we'll get in there this afternoon and really get after it. Then, of course, get ready for Pittsburgh State. And we'll probably platoon for the first half, and then the second half we'll try to get more guys ready to play. It's getting closer here. Sunday will be here before you know it.
You know anything about Pittsburgh? I mean, do they got a shooter like the other team do?
No, I'm more worried about us right here, Nate. So with that being said, we got to do a better job, I think, of guarding guys and making guys uncomfortable on the perimeter. And of course, drive them in there. And we had 12 blocked shots the other night, so let's see if we can even get more. But I want to see our guys active and being consistent, especially defensively. I think offensively we're going to be able to score. But I think key is now is we've got to get guys with the mindset of really stopping people, and our guard play has really got to step it up.
Can you sense the kids getting excited about having a game every 3 to 4 days instead of practice?
Yeah, they are. They are. They're ready to play. Like I said, they've been going at it since this summer in July. So you got so many guys that are returning back. So they spend a lot of time together, pushing each other, going against each other. And so it's that time. And so it gives me an opportunity to get some feedback and find out where we are and see it as a whole. It's one thing to have them where they split them up and with inter squad games or even in practice. But when you put it all together, you can see a lot of different things. You know, to me, the game the other night for Key, there's an opportunity for me to see him in a game setting to see what he brings to our basketball team. And that's another dimension that we didn't have, a slashing forward that's pretty athletic. I think he's could be one of the better defensive forwards that we do have, Ja'Cory Williams. His conditioning right now is really big for him, getting up and down the floor. We're going to see a lot of teams play zones, so he's a guy that can really neutralize those zones, getting in the gaps and making plays.
Have you named captains yet?
Have not. And that'll be something that'll progress. I just don't go out and name guys captain. I think that's something that's got to be earned, and hopefully we'll get closer to that.
You kind of want to see how the guys do as the season goes on.
We'll see. We hadn't had any adversity take place, so you can find out a lot more when that adversity takes place. Who are those guys that they're going to speak and speak when it's not very popular to speak and step up? And not only that, you know, you got actions behind what you say.
You know, Bobby's obviously improved his game in a lot of ways. One thing that's impressed me watching Red White in the exhibition, his ball handling. I mean, he'll get the ball off the board, and he'll just take it up like a guard. Well, what have you thought of his ball handling?
Well, that's a plus for us when you got a forward that can push the ball out down the floor. As long as he values the basketball and take care of it, I have no problem with it. It makes us more effective. But I think he did some of that last year. He may have had some turnovers doing it, but I think he's a lot much better basketball player now than he was last year. He's, as he said, he was a sponge in terms of whatever, you know, that took place last year that was of the negative. I mean, he's making it a positive because, you know, he's bettering himself to be prepared for those situations. So he's going to have a target on him. Being a guy that's peg is one of the better players in our conference, you know, I want to see how he responds, you know, when people really come at them.
You know, he said as good as he was hesitant to speak up last year, kind of deferred to the seniors. Have you seen him be more vocal in practice?
Yes. I think Bobby has. I think he wants to be that guy. And so it's one of those natural progression that you want to see it happen. But he's one of those candidates.
I guess to this point, you had some returning guys. You got a lot of newcomers. How do you think that the chemistry? How's everything meshing with the newcomers?
It's a process, like I said. But we only play one game, but I think these guys they enjoy one another. These guys spend a lot of time in the gym. I mean, they may call up. You know, I may call Dell. Hey, Dell, let's go shoot some ball. Let's go get some shots up. And that guy, they go. I mean, one of them the other day, I think they had an off day and said, let's just go bowl. I think about 6 or 7 of them just up and went bowling, I mean, on their time off. So they're doing some things off the floor, and hopefully that will translate on the floor. But I think it's a team that I think they want to be good.
You know, Keaton, he's tall, but he looks like he's got an even longer wingspan. How good is he as far as deflecting passes and just, you know, taking up space.
I think that could be one of Keaton's strengths, is be a defensive demon, you know, a specialist for us. You know, guard, go out and guard those guys, you know, that are giving us problems, especially, you know, guys with size, because, like I say, he got length. And Keaton has, like I said, he can anticipate defensively, and he's pretty active.
You said after the game that night, I feel like he's been on lockdown for you. Can you really sense how anxious he is and how excited he is to get to play in real games again?
He displayed it, I think, in that game, and hopefully there are more games he can do that.
Point guard defense, I know the way you want to play is maybe more difficult than they imagine. How do you see that transition going?
Well, it's a process. I think our guys got to understand that, you know, when you're out there on that floor, we want quality minutes. And if we're going to hang our hats on our defense, that is making it difficult for other teams' guards. And so the guy is getting too comfortable out there, and we're not doing our job. And I thought that was the case the other night, where the kid kept getting open. And I think that's got to be a team commitment. And not necessarily just on the guards. It's got to be a team commitment. So that's something I think we've got to, you know, our guard has got to learn that. And
yeah, you said several times Ja'Cory's your best conditioned guy. Did he make a new commitment to conditioning, or has he always been that way? Why is he your best conditioned
guy? I think
he
committed himself, and I think, you know, he's taking pride. The experience factor, and of course, he's been sitting there for a while. I mean, he's leading all the sprints. I mean, in anything we do, he's one of the top guys. I mean, if I say let's run 5 laps, he's finishing before anybody. So maybe that's his way of getting my attention. But little did he know, it's also helping him become, you know, giving him an advantage in terms of how we play, you know, because he can be one of those guys. He's going to be on the receiving end of a lot of alley-oops or layups because he can run the floor.